going on YouTube? You guys are watching Boxing Talk with Shaka Waka. What's going on, everybody? Yo, I just wanted to talk about how Terrence Crawford is now talking about fighting Sean Porter and saying that he will take lower pay for that fight during this COVID-19. But before I get into that, I want to say thank you to everybody who comes and likes and comments on my videos. Shout out to all my subscribers and shout out to the whole LDBC, man. Y'all the realest. And also, I want to give a big shout out to Rainier and also 89TV for hitting the Cash App on my last video. Shout out to you guys and thank you for your support. Thank you for everybody who shows support. You know, liking and commenting goes a long way as well. And also subscribing. But clicking on that link to hit up the Cash App, you know, I'm not making any money off of these videos. You know, I'm just doing this because I like to do it. So when y'all show support like that, hit me up in the Cash App, man. I'm really appreciative of that. And to anybody else who wants to donate to the channel, I'm gonna leave the link in the description and y'all can go ahead and click the link, donate how much you think I deserve for my videos, you know, if you fucking with me. And I'll be sure to give you guys a shout out in my next videos. But thank you again to 89TV and Rainier. Y'all, what's up? Y'all the real ones. Now, Terrence Crawford. Okay, earlier, I want to say this year, probably last year or some shit. I can't remember the dates. But of course, right after the Errol Spence fight, that was last year, they were talking about they want to see Sean Porter versus Terrence Crawford because, you know, Errol Spence had that performance against Sean Porter. It was, to me, it was a close fight, but with that knockdown, Errol Spence edged it out. And they, man, they was in there banging. That fight was a good-ass fight. That had to be like fight of the year material, for real, because they was in there banging, man. It was a good-ass entertaining fight from round 1 to 12. But after that, you know, Terrence Crawford, he doesn't really have anybody to fight because he's over there on Top Rank, you know, the same side of the street talking blah 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 blah. But Terrence Crawford did not want to fight Sean Porter, claiming they were friends and stuff like that. But Sean Porter was calling Terrence Crawford out, and my stance on it is, if this guy is calling you out, fight him. Fuck it, fight him. Errol Spence clearly has a different route he's gonna do, and that's a, I feel a certain way about that too. I feel like, before I even get into Errol Spence shit, let me just talk about the Sean Porter shit, because I'm gonna get on Errol Spence in a minute. But this Sean Porter fight, Terrence Crawford, he's now saying he will fight him, you know, during this COVID-19, but he will take lower pay for that. I'm wondering why he has changed his approach to things anyway. I like it. Don't get me wrong. I like that he has changed his approach, because I want to see him fight Sean Porter. Like I said, I think he could beat him. It's going to be a tough-ass fight for him because of Sean Porter's style, and Sean Porter gives anybody a tough fight. But I think Terrence Crawford has the ability to adapt in the ring, adapt to any style. So I give him the edge to win. And the fact that Sean Porter doesn't have that much power to his punches, I think Terrence Crawford edges on that as well. The main thing that Sean Porter really has is his athleticism and his chin. The nigga has a great chin. That's why when Errol Spence put him down, it was like, damn. Like, we seen Adrian Broner do it, but that was more like a flash knockdown, and that was, it wasn't like how fucking Errol Spence did it. You seen that Sean Porter was out on his feet, and then he quickly recovered, though. That's the thing about Sean Porter, that fucking chin he has is amazing. So I do want to see how Terrence Crawford goes against Sean Porter and see how his power stacks up to Sean Porter's chin, you know what I'm saying? And like I said, I think that fight is going to be hard for him, but I think he'll edge it out. And now let me talk about Errol Spence. So I said that Terrence Crawford should fight Sean Porter because that's a credible fight. That's a credible name. It's going to be tough for him. And he would really stamp himself at the welterweight division by beating the Sean Porter. You know what I'm saying? Errol Spence clearly has a different route. You know what I'm saying? He has a different route. So why not fight Sean Porter? This is a thing about Errol Spence, and I love Errol Spence to death. My second favorite fighter in the sport. But I can't sit here and act like I didn't see this nigga go a whole different route like Anthony Joshua. I'm just being honest. Like, people talk shit about Anthony Joshua, how he said he was gonna go a different route. He was gonna get the belts first, and then he gonna fight you know, Wilder. You know, I see the same thing with Earl Spence. I don't see how don't nobody see that. When they was talking shit face to face after whatever fight they was at, and Earl Spence let it be known, like, I'm not fighting you. I'm fighting this person because it's the easier route. You know what I'm saying? And Terrence Crawford is making it, he disrespecting you, saying that you ducking him, you in his face. And Terrence Crawford is in your face disrespecting you, telling you you ducking him. He has a belt. Y'all can unify. Why be strategic in this whole thing? Like, I don't understand what's the prop. Like, what is that? Now we have Terrence Crawford talking about he going up in weight or he going down in weight, because the fight he really wants, he can't seem to get. Because at the end of the day, Errol Spence holds the card because he's on PBC and everybody's over there. But I'm not gonna sit here and act like he didn't do what Anthony Joshua did by fighting all these other people first, and then every fight he's talking about, I'm gonna fight Wilder, but it never seems to happen. Other people jump in the way, you know. And this car crash for Errol Spence, it doesn't really help this situation, because now I don't see them fighting anytime soon. Because we have to see how he stacks up against Danny Garcia. And if I'm Danny Garcia, I'm aiming straight for Errol Spence's mouth the whole fucking fight. Like, that's who what I'm about to hit. Because since he got into that that car crash, I'm aiming right for his mouth the whole time. You know, that's what was fucked up in the whole fight. And that could change. I mean, that was fucked up in the car crash. So hitting him there can change the whole fucking dynamic of the fight. You know what I'm saying? So we have to see how Errol Spence even, you know, takes this fight with Danny Garcia. If he even is going to fight Danny Garcia, because now I'm hearing that Danny Garcia is going to fight Pacquiao and all this shit. That's why people just need a fight when the fucking fight is available. And I think the fight been available, you know, but this whole on two sides of the street shit, y'all just need to really fucking sit down and have a conversation. I don't think they really have sat down and divided the money up. I feel like Errol Spence wants more of that money. He wants to be the A side of that whole situation, whatever. But that doesn't tell me that you really want to fight. Because when AJ was talking about that A side, B side shit, people was like, fuck AJ, he ducking. Why it got to be A side, B side? But when it comes to Errol Spence, there could be an A side, B side. I don't understand that. You know what I'm saying? People turn around, it's business. It's business now. But when it was Wilder and Joshua, it wasn't business. Like, when did it stop being business? That's the whole thing I don't really understand about Errol Spence. He's a great fighter, and I think he still has shit to prove. Like, I feel like he's a good ass fighter, but this A side, B side talk, it is what it is. You know what I'm saying? It is what it is. I don't like that about this whole situation. But of course I got Terrence Crawford in that fight. But anyway, I think I like the talk that Terrence Crawford is talking. He'll take lower pay to fight Sean Porter during this COVID-19. I think it's the right move to do. And I hope he goes through with it. You know what I'm saying? I hope he goes through with it and shows us his ability up at the 147-pound division. You know, it's about time. Like, he's dominated in his fights at 147. I want to see him get in there with somebody that's really going to tussle with his ass. You know what I'm saying? But besides that, man, like I said, I like the talk from Terrence Crawford. I think it needs to happen ASAP. And I think that's the fight that needs to happen next. And then I want to see Errol Spence and him. I want them to get this shit over with. Because backing up and backing up and backing up, it looked like we ain't never going to get the fight. Then we'll have shit like the shit that's happening in 154 or Wilder and Fury shit like that. You know what I'm saying? If the opportunity is there, they need to jump all over it. And that's how I feel. But yeah, that's all I got for you guys. Thank you guys for watching. Like I said, if y'all want to hit the Cash App, I'll leave the link in the description. And thank you guys. Y'all stay blessed. Peace.